for the cheapest, fastest, most reliable muck coins in the market, check out my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com and use discount code MONEY for 3% off. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Sniff out the man cheese as always. Got some more plays for you guys today out of the Raiders playbook. That's right. I just put an ebook from the Raiders. It's one of the best playbooks in the game. I don't know if it's better than my Niners. It's probably, you know, those are 1 and 2 in my eyes. I got the Ravens coming out pretty soon. I'm probably going to try to have the Colts and stuff like that. Let me know in the comment section what playbooks you guys want to see. I'll put up a poll just like I did last time. The Raiders were the winners of the last poll, and that's why that they came out first. But without a doubt, it's one of the better playbooks in the game. I'm really glad you guys put me onto it. It's a really good playbook. I have a lot of really good plays to show you guys, including the 3 run plays I'm going to show you guys today. So as always, if you guys want to see more out of this offense, hit the like button and let me know in the comment section. Now, the formation itself is out of the strong wing. To me, the strong is probably the best formation to run out of. I've already put out plays from the Niners from the strong. These just have some of the best run plays. And this one here with the two tight ends to the one side is definitely something that's really going to be overpowered as well. The plays themselves is really only 3. I'll go ahead and put them in my audibles, although the power is already there. I think the inside zone was already there too. Yeah, the inside zone weak's one of them. And then the last one, which is probably the best in my opinion, the most explosive anyway, is the halfback counter weak. I've probably put this play out in the past. So those are the 3 plays: the inside zone weak, the power O, and the counter weak. I'll probably show a pass play towards the end, maybe the PA power O. I'm not really sure. That's a good one. The PA slide's a really good one. Now, as always, this video is brought to you by my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com. If you guys want to get your Mutt team up and support this channel at the same time, all you have to do is click the link in the description and use discount code MONEY to get 3% off, and you guys really help me out with that. So check them out, link in the description below. So the reads on a play like this are simple. I wish I had a stretch play, but the power L really replaces the stretch play and is a good play. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to start off with that, because this first play here looks like a cover 3. If I'm right, that cornerback will shoot back out of the play and basically take himself out to the point where it's like I don't even really have to worry about him. Now, I still ran right into that cornerback, so it wasn't the best execution, but it was a cover 3. So basically, you know, once again, this here got a strong safety or in the box on this side, so I'm just going to go with the power. I mean, I'm pretty much just going to take this to the edge anytime I have an opportunity. Like I said, I'll just treat this like a stretch play, and you can see we just basically take it outside. It's not a traditional stretch play. You don't take it outside all the way. So as far as these runs go, you really only have 3 run plays. The inside zone weak is probably the easiest. There's no real this is going to be a play. If you want to get a consistent 5 yards, this is going to be the play, and it's probably the play that I'm going to run the most. The counter weak is going to be if you're taking a shot, an explosive play, and then the power O is kind of in the same vein. As far as the differences between these two plays, you're going to want to run the counter weak and the inside zone the exact same way. Anytime you have a spread defensive alignment, if your opponent's trying to take away outside runs, they spread their defense, or they don't have the, you know, the box tightly packed, the counter weak and the inside zone weak are going to be the best plays. If they're pinching the defense, then the power O is going to be the best way, because you're going to try to treat the power O kind of like a cover 3. So this here looks a little bit more spread. I'm going to go with something like this. Like I said, I'm going to take a shot here. This is a play if you're trying to make an explosive run, you go with the counter weak. Now right there, there was a guy in the box. Probably should have ran to the left a little bit more. I think there was space, but you can see how that had success. Let's go and let's do that again. This looks like a blitz. I don't want to mess around the backfield too much on a blitz, so we're just going to run the stragglers, the regular zone weak, and now you can see how we just find spacing. So we're not going to spend a ton of time going over the inside zone, because we want to get some explosive runs here. So this looks like it's probably cover 3. We're going to go with our power, because this is the closest thing to a cover 3. You can see that fullback gets out there and does a terrific job taking out that cornerback. That's why this is such a successful run formation. You got 2 tight ends and a fullback. You're going to have a lot of success running against just about any formation. So here we have, you know, strong side. A lot of times your opponent's really going to be shifting to that strong side because they're afraid of the strong side runs. That's why the counter is so successful. I mean, there's a number of reasons, but you can see once again, nothing really there. The counter is really an interesting read when it comes to what you're looking for. Let's go to the replay. Typically, when you're running the ball, you want outside containment. This is the exact opposite. When it comes to counters, you want them to have outside containment. When I say that, I mean you want their widest box player to be outside of your widest blocker. The reason for that's really easy, because typically you let him in free and he takes himself out of the play. The pulling guard comes in and seals that edge. You don't want to try to go outside of this guy. You want to go inside of him pretty much every time. So whenever you're running a counter play, you're basically setting this guy up. You want him to be outside of this guy. If you're running a power or a stretch, typically you want this guy to be outside of their widest box player. So there we go. Once again, we got, you know, obviously you don't want to run a counter here. You got that box safety over the top. We're going to go ahead. We're going to go the other way. We're gonna, like I said, we're going to treat this like it's a stretch play. Only, you know, we can go inside or we can go outside, but you can see there's nothing really out here. So even though it's not a traditional stretch play, you have something that's pretty close in this power run. And that's how you want to play it all game. You could go counter weak, you can go power. Go one side wide or go, you know, the other side wide. So we're going to show two pass plays. We'll put them in our audibles, the PA slide and the PA power O. Just like the power O and the counter weak, we're going both ways with this. So it's going to be very hard to decide pre-snap if you're going over the middle or you're going outside. So that's how this is, you know, this makes a very good scheme. Because you can go in multiple directions, it's going to be very hard for your opponent to pre-diagnose pre-snap. The only thing is you want to make sure that you have, you know, you want to take your fullback out. Unless you have a really good receiving fullback, which isn't typical, put in a running back at the fullback spot. So these two plays here, the PA slide and the PA power O, you can see that the routes go in exact opposite directions. So this is a run first formation, a very run heavy formation. Your opponent's going to be biting on the play action pretty much every time. It's going to give you advantage. Now the biggest advantage you can have is, like I said, you can go both ways. Now against zone coverage, this play is going to be best. Against man coverage, this play is going to be best. So I don't know if this is a zone or a man, but I think it's a man or a zone. So we're going to go, we're going to pick this one. We're just going to put the A route here on a streak. And that's pretty much it. You still have a zone beater. I mean, obviously this running back here, you can take that in the flats, but the tight end's going to get open above him pretty much against every zone coverage. If you guess wrong, you have your man beater in the X route. So it's not the end of the world, but you can see right here, this guy here is not a very good tight end, and we're getting very big plays outside of whatever the zone coverage is. It doesn't matter. Cover two, cover three, cover four. It's going to be the same results. All you have to do is streak the A route. And then, like I said, the RB route is a very good check down. Here we got a cover two. You can see it gets outside of that. If I put Darren Waller there, I'd probably be getting one play touchdowns. I'd probably be getting even better results. But ultimately, I'm not going to make that adjustment because that might be the Darren Waller effect. Here we have that that zone coverage I was telling you about, or that man coverage I was telling you about, messed it up. The drag was still there, but you know, like I said, if you get man coverages, it's really gonna be best to be running the PA slide. Your RB route is your zone beater, but pretty much everything else beats man. And to be honest with you, they all pretty much beat zone as well. As you can see right here, I definitely waited too long to make my decision, but Darren Waller, you're basically just playing three levels of passing here. It's really, you're just going from the fullback back to the tight end, back to the receiver. That's really all you have to do. If it's something like this, I mean, I could probably throw it right away, but it's three levels of passing. You have your shortest route. If it's there right away, take it, catch it, and run. I find if you're going to run that as well, it's best to motion this guy across in most formations, but you can't do that in this formation. So in this formation, I don't find that he gets into the flats quick enough, but you can see right there, that's a man coverage. He beats him out there pretty quickly because you can't get across. So if he's there, take it. Like I said, all these routes pretty much beat man and zone depending on who you have running it. So Waller, he's probably going to beat just about anybody. Here we have that the tight end was kind of in the way. Got to take the deepest route. Obviously, it's the biggest gain as well. So that's really the concept. The PA slide's a really easy concept. I haven't gotten a man coverage yet for Waller, although this might be. Not really sure. I looked like it was a cover four quarters the way he was leading him. That typically happens in cover four quarters, but you can see he's going to get open against that. So, you know, just front to back. It's a really easy read. I mean, just, you know, shortest route to deepest route. Here we go again. That might have been a cover four quarters again because he's doing a pretty good job of covering them. And we're getting some very big plays, although all three of those routes will beat man coverage. The A route will beat man coverage. The X route will beat man coverage. The RB route will typically not, unless if he's really far behind him, like he is right here. Here we get that Waller route once more. So you throw it up the field a little bit to get in bounds, and you can see it's a very easy play. So I'm gonna go ahead and end the video there. If you guys want to see more stuff out of the Raiders or whatever your favorite playbook is, let me know in the comment section or hit the like button. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Much shit out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like eBooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below.